Well, a wave of explosions has rocked Lebanon this morning. The militant group Hezbollah reports 11 people have now died when hundreds of handheld pagers exploded at the same time. Beirut is accusing Israel for what appears to be a sophisticated attack or hack that's injured now almost 4,000 people.
A major attack on Hezbollah deep inside Lebanon. It started Tuesday afternoon when pagers belonging to Hezbollah fighters blew up, causing thousands of injuries and several deaths.
A large number of injured are coming to the hospitals. They were primarily injured in the explosion of pagers they were carrying. The numbers that arrived at the emergency rooms are very big.
Hezbollah immediately blamed Israel for the explosions, suggesting Israeli forces hacked into their new pager network or tampered with the devices. The group's senior leaders say they were not hurt, and they're now vowing revenge, claiming Israel will receive, quote, retribution for this sinful aggression. It happened just hours after Israeli defense officials updated their war objectives to include restoring security in northern Israel, a move that could put them on a collision course for a broader conflict with Hezbollah.
The problem should be solved as soon as possible. The residents of the north won't return if there is no sense of security. I don't believe it. Mr. Prime Minister says he wants security, a complete victory, but after a year they are still shooting.
Meanwhile, the Biden administration is calling on both sides to resist an escalation.
Ultimately, this is something that needs to be resolved diplomatically. It's very tough to achieve a diplomatic resolution to the conflict across the blue line as long as there is ongoing conflict in Gaza.
U.S. Secretary of State Antony Blinken is on his way to Egypt to revive ceasefire talks that have been stalled.